Hello everyone, this is Kavita Reddy from Shreya Nutrition. I have been hearing a lot of reports about telugupindi or defatted sesame seed flour and its relation to COVID, that is it helps in preventing or managing COVID situation. So I read a little bit about it and I thought I will explain to you how it is related. Now sesame seeds, in Telugu they are called novulu and in Hindi til. These are basically oil seeds. They contain about 50% of oil and about 18 to 20% of protein. Now once you remove the oil from these seeds, the protein content goes up. It becomes almost 30%. That is, defatted sesame seed flour or telugupindi has 30% protein in it, and it is a very good source of protein. And one of the amino acids in this sesame seed protein is glycine, and glycine has a relation to our immune system. Now let's talk about our immune system. Our immune system is a very complex and complicated network of cells, and it works like a very well-oiled machine. It's our defense mechanism against any outside attack on our body, be it a germ or a virus or a bacteria. Now, when something attacks our, some organism attacks our body, our immune system goes into action and liberates or releases several antibodies and other substances to fight the infection. One of the released substances are cytokines, which are small proteins, and their most important function is cell signaling. There are cytokines which are pro-inflammatory and there are cytokines which are anti-inflammatory. Now when let's say a virus attacks us, to fight the infection, our body may get fever or there may be inflammation. Actually, these are good signs. That means our body is fighting the infection. So the inflammation and fever, they go up, and then when our body fights the infection, and slowly they also come down. So the fever and inflammation disappear. That means our body is rid of the infection. Now sometimes what happens is the inflammation is beyond control. Now let's take COVID for example, and in this what is happening with some serious cases in some patients, the cytokines, the release is so much more and it keeps on increasing that there is so much more inflammation and the lungs are affected. And this is called cytokine storm. Actually, the cytokines are supposed to cause inflammation and then it has to come down. But if it doesn't come down, the inflammation is more, and the patients who experience this get into a very serious situation. Now, how does this telugupindi work in decreasing this cytokine storm or in regulating the cytokine production? There are cytokines which are pro-inflammatory, and also there are cytokines which are anti-inflammatory. The amino acid glycine helps in regulating the production of cytokines. So it is theorized that having plenty of glycine in our body helps in regulating the number of cytokines being produced. So in this way, it may help in managing the production of cytokines and help in the inflammation not going out of control.
Let's talk about antioxidants now. Like any other cells in the body, even immune cells, when they function, they release some free radicals. And if these free radicals accumulate over a period of time, the function of immune cells is somewhat affected. So we have to make sure that there won't be any free radical accumulation which will cause oxidative stress in the immune cells and prevent them from working properly. Now, how do we do that? We can get antioxidants through our food, which will scavenge or clean away the free radicals from our body. Another way is our body synthesizes or makes a very powerful antioxidant called glutathione. This glutathione is a very strong antioxidant and it can help in removing the free radicals from immune cells and also other cells in the body and help the immune system to function better. Now, for making the glutathione in our body, we need glycine, the amino acid. And therefore, we need to eat foods which are rich sources or good sources of this amino acid, glycine. Coming back to telgapindi or de-oiled sesame seed flour, it is a very good source of protein. That is, it has about 30% protein. That if you take 100 grams, you have about 30 grams of protein in it. And glycine is part of this protein. So glycine, this telgapindi is a very rich source of glycine. And glycine is good for regulating cytokine production. And also it is necessary for making the very powerful antioxidant glutathione. So that is why it's very, very important. On top of it, protein is the from protein only the antibodies are made. So it's like a raw material. And telgapindi is a rich source of protein. So not only it's a source of glycine, but protein itself is good to boost immune system. And telgapindi is also a good source of iron, zinc and selenium. These are the minerals which are present in this de-oiled sesame seed cake or flour. Now these are very important for our immune system to function. So you have a protein in which glycine is there, you have iron, zinc and selenium in telgapindi or de-oiled sesame seed flour. That is why it is very important to use this as much as possible in your diet. Try to incorporate it as frequently as you can. Also, suppose you don't have telgapindi, at least start using sesame seeds regularly in your diet.
Now that we know that glycine, amino acid, helps in boosting our immune system, if you don't find defatted sesame seed flour, you can probably use sesame seeds regularly in your diet. But the only thing you have to remember is this has 50% oil. So that will contribute to putting on weight. And obesity or overweight actually brings down the immune system. So if you can't find defatted sesame seed flour or telgapindi, once in a while or start using sesame seeds in your vegetable preparation or just try to incorporate into your diet. There are other foods also which are rich in glycine, like soy granules and nuggets, pork, defatted ground nuts. All these have quite a good amount of glycine. So I hope this video was helpful. It became a little long because of all the explanations, but I hope it was helpful to you. Thank you very much for your attention.